The end of the at the Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today I swatches and review of the Lucky Bunny Greed palette. Before we go any further and before I forget, because this is the first video that I am filming after I have kinda gotten the membership part of YouTube. So if you look underneath this video, you will probably see a join button. If you click on that, you can become a member of my channel. It will be €3 per month. It will be a recurring payment and it will give you some perks. If you click that, you can see the perks, but basically you get, if you are a member, you get your own kind of a, it's kind of a raven badge that you get with your name when you comment. There are for, I think it's just for live streams, but you get special what are they called again, emojis that you can use, which are also very cute ravens, and I will pick one of my members to shout out in my Let's Talk Makeup that goes online every Monday. But yeah, you can become a member if you want to. If you don't want to, please don't feel the pressure that you need to, because watching my videos and commenting and liking and just engaging with me in the comment section is a huge help for me as well. So yeah, that was it. Before I forget to mention that, and of course now my washing machine is blaring at me that it's done. But yeah, you don't care. And neither do I right now, because this video is not about my washing machine. It is about eye swatches that I'm going to show you in just a second. And after the eye swatches, I will tell you if I think that this palette is worth your money or not. Let me quickly tell you a little bit about Lucky Bunny Cosmetics. It's an Australian-based indie brand. Very, very new. And this is the second palette that she came out with. Currently, she also has liquid lipsticks. Four shades. She has sponges and she has a waterproof eyeliner. Definitely go check her out. I will leave all her information down below. And if you decide to purchase anything from her, she was nice enough to give me a discount code, which is Nikki10, and it will save you 10%. It's not affiliated. But yeah, saving money is always good. At least I think so. The multiple looks video should be online tomorrow. I created 3 looks with this palette. And this is look number 3. If you want to jump straight ahead to the review part, you can just click the timestamp down below. In the review part, I also show you the ingredients. And basically, I tell you what I think about the palette. And if, yeah, and how it performs during a look. If I think it's worth your money. And all that goodness. Without further ado, grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up, because here come the eye swatches. Okay, okay. Eyes are primed and ready to go. I'm going to use the Kiko Milano eye base during this video. I have done the looks with the ABH eye primer, but I thought, you know what, let me get a little bit of a more hydrating primer for today's video. Both eyes are primed, they are not set, and let me start by zooming you in. Because you can then see better. Oh, that's the wrong side. Oh, I don't know why, but the lights feel very, very bright. Mars is very bright tonight. Or something like that. And I have glitter everywhere as well. So yay, fun. I'm going to use for the mattes these two brushes, which are from Sigma, the E27 and the E25. They are both the same, only one is a little bit bigger. So basically I'm going to use the smaller one for, well, at least the pinks, and probably the lighter purples, and then this one for the darker purples or something like that. And for the shimmers I have two flatter brushes. This one from Yesup that I used during the looks video for the shimmers, and this is one from Morphe. So yeah, that's what I'm going to use. I'm not going to use a glitter primer because my eyes will not like me if I do. I do, however, use a glitter primer underneath the shimmers in my looks video. And that's going to be it. I'm going to use the shimmers dry first and then spray them. Because in my opinion or my experience, if I spray the shades, it kind of functions like they would on top of a glitter primer. Foilness wise, never mind, it's the evening, just forget I said anything. I'm going to start with a color, ooh, not falling, with the color called Angel, which is a very pale pink, and that is going to go on this eye. My base is still tacky, that is good, because this is a shade that you kinda yeah, want to put on top of a sticky base because then it just shows up better. And I did use this in the looks video and it showed up nicely on top of the ABH primer. Now that one is lighter than the Kiko Milano one. And the lighter the base, the better it will show up. But it does show up for me. So yeah, basically this is it, guys. Here's the shade called Angel. Okay, then the next shade is a shimmer and it is called Bunny. And it is, I think it's my favorite shimmer from this palette. Because basically it's the shade Angel, but then in a shimmer. Oh, it's so pretty. Let's start with a dry first. My base is still a bit tacky. This is such a... Oh, this shade makes me so happy. Okay, and now I'm going to spray and I'm going to show you how I do it. So first I'm going to grab the shimmer on the brush. Let's do this one, this side for funsies. And then I'm going to spray. Now this is a mixture of water and a tiny bit of glycerin. Basically, I know that water kind of dries out brushes, but also skin. And I thought, you know what, let's put in the glycerin so it kind of stops it from drying out then. So put a humectant or whatever it's called in. It's not specifically to make the shimmers pop more, but more to keep my brushes from drying out. And it seems to work. So there isn't a lot of difference if you spray it or not. But this is what it looks like on top of a shimmer primer also. Oh, the shade called Bunny. Oh, so gorgeous. Okay. The next shade is a shimmer and it is called Amethyst. Oh, there it is. So first dry. Now my base is still a bit tacky. So basically it is... behaving, I think it's behaving like it would on top of the glitter primer. Basically how I don't even need to spray it because I know that this is basically how it looks on top of the glitter primer. Amethyst. The next shade is a matte and it is called Trixie. And I thought it would be a bluer purple, but when I blend it out... it blends out a bit more pink, at least on my skin tone. It's a bit more powdery in the pan. I don't mind it though, so I'm basically just picking it up now. It was a little bit harder pressed when I first started working with it, I remember. But yeah, it does blend out nicely, even on a sticky base. But I haven't worked with this base yet, because the ABH base is a little bit drier than this one. Not as dry as the MAC Paint Pot, but it's a bit more in between. Yeah, blends out nicely. Here's the shade called Trixie. And as you can see, when you blend it out a little bit, it turns a little bit more pink. As you can see. So yeah, let's prep the eyes for the next two. Next shade is called Candy. And it's a shimmer. Now, I do feel that more of the shimmers in this palette are kind of the foiled shimmers I'm going to spray. Than in the Envy palette. This is also such a gorgeous shade. Here's the shade called Candy. And it also kind of looks like this. Yeah, there's not really a difference. If I spray it, it's a little bit more foiled. And that is how it looks on top of the glitter primer. But it's just a very gorgeous shade. The next shade is called Danny. And it is a hot pink. My base is still a bit tacky and I haven't tapped off the brush. To just get maximum payoff. And if you want a shade like this to be as vibrant as possible, again, on a lighter base, as light as you have, basically. And on a tacky base, if you pack it on, then it gets more vibrant. But this is a shade that you can easily sheer out and you can also nicely build it up. Which is very, very good. Now, the primer I have on now doesn't have a lot of base shade to it. And again, if I use the ABH primer, it's a bit more vibrant, the color, because it's just a lighter base. So let's see how this one will blend on top of a base that is still a tiny bit sticky. And is a little bit more, not wet, but moist. It's such a dirty word, moist. I don't know what it is, but it's a little bit more moist than the ABH one. Yeah, I can see that I do prefer to work with my ABH one. And I kind of knew that because of the weather. If you are new, you may not know this. Here's the shade called Danny. But when it is warm in summertime, I prefer eyeshadow primer that's a bit drier. So for instance, the ABH or the MAC Paint Pot. If it's very, very warm, not that I have the MAC Paint Pot anymore, but that's neither here nor there. And when it is a bit colder, I prefer something like this from Kiko Milano, which is a little bit more hydrating in wintertime. But because I know that I'm going to kind of dry out my eyes doing this anyway, that is the reason that I chose the... this primer and not the ABH one, to kind of spare my eyes a little bit. But yeah, let me prep them again. I think we're going to go to Kiki and Taylor, aren't we? I hope so, otherwise I'm going to swatch them twice. But yeah, the next shade is going to be Kiki. This one is a little bit harder. Well, they are. It's not that they are very, very hard pressed in the pan, but sometimes you kind of need to wiggle your brush around a little bit, and then you can pick it up. So it's not that there's a lot of kick up in the pan. Not really. Yeah, with the lightest pink shade a little bit, but also not a lot of it. It's I don't know. But yeah, as long as you can get pigment on your brush and then on your eye, it's all good, I think. And if you feel that you kind of struggle to blend out shades, either set your base next time or, basically set your base next time, because it makes it a lot easier. Now, if you are having trouble blending it like it is now, just grab face powder to blend out the edge, or even the lighter shade here called Angel. But here is the shade called Kiki. I don't really have a problem blending these out. I'm just not taking my time because I kinda... It does not really have to look very pretty because it's an eye swatch video, and I hope that makes sense. So yeah, I'm going to wash this off. It's not that I'm going to walk around the rest of the day like this. But yeah, oh no, I wanted to try a different brush. I'm going to go to the color called Tela next. And I'm also going to try the Morphe, which is a little bit, I don't know, it's a little bit looser, almost. It picks up quite a bit of shimmer, which is good. I'm also forgetting to spray it, but it's almost, I don't know, it doesn't need it, at least not with this brush. Oh, also such a pretty color, the shade Tela. And I just love these kind of, are they maybe vintage pinks, you know, with a little hint of gray in it. Oh, I love them so, so much. I'm going to prep my eyes for the next two. Yes, last four shades and then we're done. The next shade is the shade called Lola. I also did not tap off my brush. And this formula, this Lola from this palette, I pick up quite a lot with, as you can see, by the fallout on my face. Doesn't matter though. Let's blend it out a bit. I have used this one in the Luxe Blended. And it works very, very well, especially on top of the ABH primer. It does seem to stick to this primer a little bit more, so it is a little bit harder to blend out, but it still blends. Which is all that you want, right? Okay, let me get rid of the fallout. Which wipes away easily. So here is the shade called Lola. Okay, the next shade is going to be the shade called Serenity. The last of the mattes, and then we are into the shimmers. And I have a microfiber, one of those sticky microfiber towels here as well, where I clean my brushes off in between, so there is no extra pigment left on them. Now this is a formula that is not a one dip instant pigment. Well, it is with some of the shades, but I kind of, I don't know, I wiggle my brush around and then I get pigment. So it's not very, very hard pressed, but it's also not poof, you know? It's actually, I like the way this is pressed. Okay, let's blend this a little. Now, the blend isn't perfect, but I'm not trying to be perfect. I'm just trying to show you that it will blend on top of a sticky base. But here is the shade called Serenity. Okay, the last two shades. We're going to start with a color called Sandy. Both are shimmers, the last two. And this shade is, I think, the less foiled of them all. And it is a gorgeous shade to put all over the lid. But it is, for me, not foiled enough to use it as an inner corner highlight. But it is very pretty on the lid. I'm going to spray. And that makes it a little bit more vibrant, but not very more shiny. So this is, I think, more of your traditional shimmer and not as shimmery as the rest of the shimmers. Wow. Okay, let's then do the last shade of the palette, which is called Storm, which is a gorgeous dark gray. And this is a little bit of the same formula as the shade Sandy that I just used. I don't know, but because it is darker, it almost seems more shiny than that one, while it is the same formula. Or at least that's what it feels like. I don't really know how to explain it. But these glide on the eye without any issue. Very pretty. And this is a gray with a bit of a... also almost a little bit of a more of a brownie base, if that makes any sense at all. But here's the shade called Storm. It's a very, very pretty shade. Okay, those were all the shades. And now I'm going to insert the old Lola versus the new Lola. So here is the shade called Lola from the Greed palette. Let me put the one from the Envy palette on the other side, because I wanted to compare the two. I did compare swatch both in the first impression, but I kind of want to see how they compare side by side, because I did see a difference and I did feel that there was a difference in formula. But let's see. Yeah, it feels, I don't know, almost a little bit more dry, if that makes any sense. Just seeing how it goes on my eye. This is the same brush, it's just bigger, so it shouldn't be make any difference whatsoever. Wow, that was not good English at all. I was trying to talk English with Dutch grammar. That's not, that does not really work correctly. I don't know, I feel that the Lola in the Greed palette, so this Lola, is better than the Lola I'm working with now. It's easier to blend, it's softer, it goes on nicer, it's just better. The color is slightly different, but it is very, very slight. I feel that the Lola in the Greed palette, so that Lola is a little bit more... gray almost, and this one seems to have a little bit more red in it, but I'm also struggling more blending it out. So yeah, can you see the difference? And I don't know what she did with this Lola, but this Lola is way, way better. I know that she changed the formula because I asked her, and she tweaked it a bit. This one is better, but here are both Lolas side by side. So this is the Lola, the new one, from the Greed palette, and this is the Lola from the Envy palette. So yeah, I just wanted to show them to you side by side. Yeah, so I kind of filmed that earlier, but otherwise you would be in the war. But let me kind of give you some additional thoughts. Do I have any additional thoughts? No, besides the fact that I feel that this is a different formula than her green palette. I think this formula is very, very nice. Now, purples are notoriously hard to formulate, or at least I have been told, and I have some bad purples in my collection. But these are not bad. These are actually very, very good. In my humble opinion. So you saw me pack them on. They packed on nicely. They blended out nicely. But most important is, how do they perform while creating an eye look? And my past self of this morning is going to tell you exactly how she feels about that. So you just saw me swatch every shade on the eyeball. And now we are back in a full face again. let me tell you a little bit more about the palette, I think. It is just a very simple cardboard palette, which I really, really like. There's no mirror in here, which I also like, because yeah, it kind of saves weight, it saves cost, and that is also good. But it's better for the environment. I don't really use mirrors in palettes, but I do know that if you like to travel a lot, which is kind of mute now anyway, a lot of people do like it, but it's not here. It's a cardboard palette, and the ingredients are here on the back. So let me show you the ingredients. I got some questions if there was talc in here. There's not, as you can see. The palette is vegan and cruelty free. So yeah, Those were the ingredients. Yeah. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 shimmers and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 mattes in here, 12 shades, so it's even. Let's kind of stay with how the shimmers perform first. The shimmers are very pretty. There are some different formulas in here. This one is a little bit of again, a little bit more of an old-fashioned shimmer almost. This could have been either a dark gray matte or a really nice foiled light inner corner shade for me, because I feel that this is a little bit, I like it on the lid, but I don't think it's popping enough to put it in the inner corner. That is me. That is, I think, the only negative thing I have to say about the shimmers. The rest are so, so pretty. This shade, I think, it's so, oh, it's such a gorgeous, gorgeous gray pink shade. Oh, I love it. And this is very, very nice. Well, I have it on the lid today and I think it's gorgeous. For me, that these darker shades are foiled enough. This is how I like those types of darker shimmers, you know. And this is just, I think this is the favorite shade that I have in the palette. It's gorgeous. I can make all the shades show up. So let's kind of go to the mattes then and how they perform. I love this shade as well. I can make it show up, no problem at all. And I think it's a very, very nice shade to have. And you can use it to blend out all the shades that you have here. The purples are a little bit more pink based. So even this one that I started with today, I thought maybe is a little bit of a bluer purple. It's actually not, because if you can see it, it blends out pinker. It could be that it blends out pinker on my skin tone, but it's just the base shade isn't as blue as I would have liked it to be. On the other hand though, I do think it makes the palette a little bit more versatile. The shade Lola is a repeat shade from her last palette, and I'm not really a fan of repeat shades. However, she changed the formula between the last palette and this palette. This shade Lola is a little bit different in tone than her first Lola, and I show you that in the first impression because I swatched them side by side. This shade is a little bit more gray, and the other Lola is a little bit more, almost has a little bit more red. Reddish brown in it, I think. This shade is better. It's better quality. It's easier to work with. It is just as pigmented as the other shade, but it blends easier. I used the Anastasia Beverly Hills eyeshadow primer in the looks video. That one dries down on its own, but I still wanted to use the shadows on a tacky base as well, and it blends beautifully. And if you are not comfortable with working on a tacky base, you can always start with this shade lightly and then, you know, work on a set base or use your face powder if you don't really want to have that pink but really want to have more of the grayish purpleness of shade Lola. In my opinion, this is a palette, if you like the color story, don't sleep on this palette, because purples are notoriously hard to formulate, and this is such a good quality. It is better than her first palette, guys. You don't need to set your base if you want to. If you do want to, you can set your base. You can layer. I layered 3 shadows on top of each other. I don't layer usually more than 3 shadows. But I do layer, because that is how I prefer to build up my looks. And it went without a hitch. I don't have any problems with patchiness. I don't have any problems with blending. It's just, the quality is just so, so good. The shimmers are gorgeous. The only shimmer that is a little bit, yeah, lackluster maybe in my opinion, is the shade called Sandy. I wish that this one was foiled. Because I could have used it easier in my inner corner, but again, as a lid shade, I think it is very, very pretty. I know the purples kind of look similar, but looking at how this one blends out, I could have even said, you know what, maybe this one, a darker gray, or a gray, yeah, basically this, but then in a matte. I would have loved to seen that in this palette, because I personally love to use that in combination with a very pale pink. But that is me. I do like the fact that we have the hot pink in here. So you can go purple, or you can go hot pink, or you can go, I don't know, whatever direction you kind of want to go. I really like this quality, guys. I think the quality is amazing. I love the color story. I cannot wait to see her next palette. You betcha I'm going to get that one as well. This was it. Let me know down below if you have this palette. If you want a palette, if you do want a palette, don't forget that I have a code that you can use if you want to. You don't have to, of course. It's just, yeah, whatever floats your boat, basically. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. Stay safe, stay healthy, try to stay sane. And I will see you tomorrow for the multiple looks video. Bye, guys.